हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ दिवस जोशी। आई वंस अगेन वेलकम यू ऑल इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, आई होप दैट यू ऑल मस्ट बी एंजॉयिंग एंड लविंग माय वीडियोस। सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू फाइंड दोस वीडियोस यूजफुल, देन आई रिक्वेस्ट यू टू काइंडली लाइक एंड शेयर देम अमंग योर फ्रेंड्स एंड कलीग्स, एंड डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल। फ्रेंड्स, माय टुडेज टॉपिक व्हिच आई विल बी प्रेजेंटिंग हियर इज क्रिटिकल पाथ मेथड। सो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अ टॉपिक व्हिच नीड्स नो इंट्रोडक्शन। It is one of the most complex and toughest topic of this exam in particular. So friends, for your easy explanation, I have designed a project which is like this. Two employees of company Ram and Shyam has to reach Chennai from Delhi to attend a meeting. Ram is a supervisor and entitled to travel by train. Shyam, being manager, is entitled to travel by air. Ram took 3 days to travel by train and Shyam took 1 day to travel by air. How long it will take to complete the project? So how we will proceed? So first of all, we will have the breakdown of our project or work. Since this is a very simple project as I have designed for the sake of explanation, so I can say that Ram and Shyam to reach Chennai and attend the meeting. This is what my project is. Now I will define my activities. So my first activity will be movement of Ram from Delhi to Chennai, and I will be describing this activity by R. And this activity is taking 3 days. As you can see here, Ram is taking 3 days to reach Chennai from Delhi. My second activity will be movement of Shyam from Delhi to Chennai. I will be describing this activity as S, and this activity is taking 1 day. Now I need to check the sequence of the activities. So since I have taken a very basic activity for the sake of explanation, so I can say both activities A and activity B are independent of each other, because both activities are no way correlated. Now next, what I need to do, I need to draw a project network diagram. So let's see how I can draw it. Suppose this is my start point, which is nothing but Delhi. This is my end point, which is nothing but Chennai. Now I will draw my activities on this network diagram. My first activity is movement of Ram from Delhi to Chennai. I will represent the activity like this. And since this activity is taking 3 days, so I will write it as R, which denotes the activity, and I will be writing the 3 in the bracket, which will denote that this activity R is taking 3 days to get completed. Similarly, my next activity, which is S and taking 1 day to get itself completed. So I will write it like this. So now I will talk in terms of activity, because I have reduced the movement of Ram and Shyam accordingly into R and S. Now looking at this project network diagram, I can say that this activity will take 3 days, this activity will take 1 day to get completed, and my work or my project will get completed only when both Ram and Shyam have reached here. So I can say my project or my work will get completed only when both the activities R and S would get completed. Now it is very easy to realize Ram is taking 3 days, Shyam is taking 1 day, so ultimately the work, which is the meeting scheduled, will be finishing 3 days. So you can say my project is getting finished or my project is getting completed in 3 days. Now suppose Shyam started his movement immediately, Shyam will reach at the end of first day. Now how will this activity, that is reaching of Shyam on the first day itself, how it will affect the company's revenue. So you can say if the Shyam is reaching here on the very first day, then Shyam has to wait for 2 days, because the meeting can be held once Ram has reached Chennai, and this will take 3 days. So Shyam has to wait for 2 days at Chennai. Now you can see here, if Shyam has to wait 2 days here, then company has to arrange hotel for his accommodation, which is a downside for the company, as the company has to invest some part of its revenues. The company has to pay daily expenses for the 2 days, which is a downside for the company. And again, loss of work at Delhi will also happen, because Shyam is waiting here for the 2 days, so he cannot do any work. So what you can see from here, that it is not feasible for Shyam to reach Chennai at the first day itself. So from here we can realize that every activity has got its optimum time, so that it can be done or it can be utilized in a more efficient way. So this activity or the movement of Shyam on the very first day will not be considered as economical. That is, this activity will not be considered as optimum. So from this, what we learned? We learned that each activity which is involved in a project is having an optimum time associated with itself. So how we can find out that optimum time? To calculate that optimum time for each of the activity, 4 parameters are required. Now we will see what are those 4 parameters. Parameters of activity. Now to calculate the optimum time for each activity, the first parameter is how fast an activity can start. The second parameter is how fast an activity can be completed. The third parameter is how late an activity can be started. And the fourth parameter is how late can an activity be finished. Now suppose we are having an activity A which is taking T time to get itself completed. Now this activity is taking T time to get completed. Now I will calculate all the 4 parameters. And yes, one thing you should remember, that for all these 4 parameters, the prime condition is that our work should not get delayed. So we have to calculate, so how fast an activity can be started such that our work should not get delayed, or you can say the work will get finished in its scheduled time. Similarly, how fast an activity can be completed such that our work should not get delayed. Similarly, how late can an activity be started such that our work should not get delayed. Similarly, how late can an activity be finished such that our work should not get delayed. So let's see how we will progress. Suppose we have activity A which takes T time to get itself completed. So how fast I can start this activity A? So suppose if A is the first activity in the network, so I can start the activity immediately. So you can start the activity A fastest on 0 day itself. Now if you start the activity as fast as you can, then the activity will definitely going to get completed as fast as possible. So if the activity is taking T time to get itself completed, so how fast an activity can be completed will be 0 plus T, or you can say the time which will be calculated for the first part plus T, that is the time which the activity takes to get itself completed. Now we come to the next two part. How late can activity be started and how late can activity be finished? Now here you have seen that how fast an activity can be completed is ultimately depending on how fast an activity can start, because the time which the activity is taking to get itself completed is fixed. But the case is reversed with the third and fourth part, that is how late can an activity be started or how late can an activity be finished. Suppose in this case Shyam has started his journey one day late, then he would have reached Chennai on the second day. Now suppose the Shyam started on the second day, then he would have reached Chennai on the third day itself. Now suppose I assume that Shyam is starting on the third day. So in this case he would be reaching here the fourth day, which is not possible. Suppose Shyam started on the third day and reaches Chennai on the fourth day, then what will happen? Then this meeting will get delayed, because now Ram has to wait here for one day. So you can say the project will get delayed if Shyam started on third day. So this is the last when Shyam can reach Chennai, or you can say this is the last when the activity can be finished. So what you can correlate from here? So you can say, just by having a look at this network diagram, the late the Shyam can finish this activity, or you can say the late the Shyam can reach Chennai is 3 days itself. So from here one thing is very clear: if you go by how late this activity can be started, you are having various combinations. So you have to go all through these combinations if you consider how late this activity can be started. So leaving this, I will calculate this thing first: how late can an activity be finished. So if you see here, the project is getting completed on third day. Basically the project is taking 3 days to get completed. So how late this activity can be completed, or how late Shyam can reach Chennai? So by using the common sense, we will be having our answer as 3 days. So if Shyam reaches Chennai beyond 3 days, the meeting will not be going to happen on the third day, and accordingly our project will get delayed. And remember, our prime concern while calculating the four parameters is that our work should not get delayed. Now if this activity has to finish on the third day, then corresponding to this, at what time this activity would start? So as we know that this activity is taking one day to get itself completed, so the start time such that the activity finishes on the third day will be the time at which the finish is required minus the time which is taken by this activity, and this will come as 2. Now suppose this activity A can be last finished on X, such that our work or project is not getting delayed. So the last that activity can be started, X minus T, where T is the time required by this activity. Now I think it is very much clear. Now suppose if we look at these four parameters, so this is the fastest time an activity can be started such that the work is not getting delayed, and this is how late can our activity be started such that our work is not getting delayed. So I can say that my optimum value for start of activity will be in between 1 and in between 3rd, which is nothing but if I start my activity at any time between these two periods, my project will not get delayed. This means simply I am having a margin available with me for getting this activity done such that my project is not getting delayed. So what will be that margin? So that margin can be calculated as third minus 1, or you can say 1 minus third, because you have to consider only the numerical value. Similarly, if I add t on both sides, what this will become? This will become how fast can an activity be completed, and what this will become? This will become how late can an activity be finished or completed. So accordingly, I can also say the margin in getting my activity completed is second minus 4 or 4 minus second. Both ways you can calculate it, because you are ultimately bothered about the numerical value. I will incorporate these four parameters in our current question, and we will see what will be the different values of all the four parameters. So how fast my activity R can start? So I can start it immediately, and there is no activity preceding to this one. So how fast can an activity be start? That will be 0. If I have started the activity on 0, then how fast this activity will be completed? Since R is taking 3 days, so this activity can be completed fastest on. So 0 plus time taken by this activity, which is 3, and this will become as 3. And one thing you should also take note here, that the fastest start time and the fastest finishing time, I am writing on the top of the arrow. I will recommend you that you should also follow the same pattern, so that a uniformity can be maintained as and when you are asking and I am explaining you the question. Similarly for S, how fast you can start this activity. So there is no activity which is preceding this activity, so you can start this activity immediately, or you can say at 0 hours or 0 days itself. So now when you have started this activity fastest on 0 day, so this activity will get completed fastest also accordingly on 0 plus time taken by this activity, which is 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. So I have written as this, just like the way I have written for the activity R. Now I will be calculating how late can an activity be started and how late can an activity be finished. So as I have told you, for calculating the third parameter, I need to first calculate how late can an activity be finished. The project is getting completed on 3 days, and R is a single activity between the start and end of the project. So I can say it very comfortably how late this activity R can be finished. So it will be very easy to say that the late this activity can be finished will be 3. Because if I finish this activity beyond the third day, then my project will get delayed. So my prime concern is that I have to see how late can an activity be finished, keeping my project within time. So if the R activity is finishing last on third day, so accordingly it need to be started on 0 day itself, because the activity R is taking 3 days. As I have already told you, how late can I start the activity is nothing but how late can I finish the activity minus the time the activity takes to complete itself. I think it is very easy to see. I am not going into much detail. Accordingly, I will calculate the third and fourth parameters for this. Now you also see that I am writing the late start time and the late finish time below the arrow. Now again you can see here, the project is getting completed in 3 days, so the last this activity S can be finished will be 3. So if we have to keep our project in time, the last this activity can be finished will be 3 days. So accordingly, when I need to start the activity, so I need to start the activity on second day. Why? Because the activity takes one day to complete itself from the same concept. So I need to start my activity on second day so as to complete the activity on the last day. Now if you see here, by having a look here, what this represents? This represents how fast I can start my activity so that my job is getting done on time. And this is how fast I need to finish my activity so that my project is getting completed on time. And this how late I can start my activity are such that my job or my project is getting completed on time. And this is how late I can finish my activity such that my job is getting finished on time. Now it is very easy to see from here that both the time, the fastest time to start an activity or the last time to start the activity such that the project is not getting delayed are equal. So in this scenario, I can say that R is having no margin of time, and similarly S is having a margin of 2 days. You can also calculate it from here itself, which is early start minus late start, early finish minus late finish, early start minus late start, early finish minus late finish. In both the cases, you will be getting the same margin as I have calculated. Now suppose R, who is traveling by train, and the train was delayed by 1 day. So you can very easily see from here, if the journey of R is getting delayed by 1 day, my project will also get delayed by 1 day. It is very simple to see here. You can easily realize here that if this R will take another 1 day, that is, he is taking 4 days, so my work or my project will get completed on the 4th day itself. So what can I say? That this activity cannot be delayed, and my this activity is falling on this path. So from here we can see that I am having no margin for this activity R, or even I can see directly from here, if R is getting delayed, then accordingly my work, which is right now completing in 3 days, will also correspondingly get delayed. So I can say this is path where I cannot afford to get my activity delayed. So this kind of path is nothing but is called as critical path. Why it is called critical path? Because the activities on the critical path cannot be delayed without delaying the project. So accordingly, this activity R cannot be delayed without delaying the project. So this is called as critical path, and this is called as activity on critical path. One thing you also realize, for the critical path there will be no margin. So you can see here that S is having a margin of 2 days. Now I think the concept of critical path method, how I have calculated the various parameters using these examples, is very much clear to you. Now friends, if you have gone through the guidebooks of the Bureau of Energy Efficiency, especially the first book and the corresponding chapter of the critical path method, you will see that the time corresponding to 1 is being given as ES, which is nothing but earliest start time. This time is given as EF, which is nothing but earliest finish time. This time is being given as LS, which is latest start time, which is nothing but how late we can start. So similarly, you can say the fourth time, that is how late can an activity with finished is nothing, but which is given as LF, which is nothing but latest finish. That is how much late we can finish an activity such that my project is not getting delayed. And also the margin, which I have told you, is nothing but float / slack, as you will found in the book. And as I have already given you the formula, the float will be calculated as late start minus early start, or it can also be given as latest finish time minus earliest finish time, as I have already explained you very clearly. Now I think it is very much clear that the latest start time will be greater than the earliest start time, and the latest finish time will be greater than the earliest finish time. Now one thing more you should realize here, that for calculating the what I will call as now earliest start time and earliest finish time, I have moved in the forward direction. That is, first I have calculated the earliest start time and then I have calculated the earliest finish time. So I will call this as a forward pass calculation. And for calculation of latest start and latest finish time, I have calculated in the backward direction. What this means, I have first calculated the latest finish time, and then from this I have subtracted the time which the activity takes to get itself completed, so as to calculate the latest start time. So this is called as backward pass calculation. Hope this is very much clear to you. So what we need to do in the network diagram, for getting the critical path, we need to calculate the margin or the float. So what we need to do in this network diagram, we need to calculate the activities in the network diagram for which this ES, that is earliest start time, is equal to the late start time. Because if earliest start time is equal to latest start time, this means no margin is available. Or I can also say there is no float, or float is zero. So this activity cannot be delayed. Suppose I have some extra revenues with me and I want to invest such that I want to accelerate my project and I want to complete my project before time. So where I will invest those resources? So from here it is very much clear. If you invest your revenues here, then you can have your project completed much before. Suppose if you arrange a flight ticket for Ram, then this activity will also be getting completed in one day, and whole of your project will get completed in one day. So now you must have realized the importance of critical path, because the activities on the critical path, if get delayed, the project is bound to get delayed. Suppose if you get some extra revenues or some extra incentives from somewhere, which you can invest in your project such that your project gets completed before time, so you have to invest those resources in those activities which are lying on critical path. So friends, now you must realize that I have taken a very simple diagram or a simple network. So you can also say that what is the use of all these concepts, because you can easily see from the diagram itself that the project is going to be completed on the third day. There is no margin for R, because if this gets delayed, the project will definitely get delayed, and there is a margin of 2 days for Shyam. These things you can easily correlate from here itself. Now suppose your network diagram is like this. So here you can easily see, you cannot calculate all those four parameters which I have calculated here just at your glance. So you need to calculate all the parameters like this, and then you can have your critical path. Friends, one thing more, as I have drawn here, these two points are called as nodes. So how this network diagram can be drawn and how this network diagram can be solved? So I will be taking all these things in my next video. So I request you, so before moving to the concept, how to draw the network diagram and how to solve this. Basically, there are only two parts which are there in this critical path analysis. The two things which are important for this analysis is first to draw this network diagram, and second to calculate the various parameters, as I have already told you, that is ES, EF, LS and LF. So I will be taking this in my next video. And friends, I will highly recommend you that before watching my next video, which will be on the network diagram and the analysis of the critical path, you must go through this video so that you can easily comprehend the things which I will explain you in my video, which will deal with the network diagram and the analysis of critical path. So friends, this is all for the day. I hope that you must have enjoyed this video and your concepts regarding the critical path method would also have been clear. So I hope I was able to clear your misconcepts, and if you are not having the misconcepts, then I would have definitely built the concepts of yours regarding this topic. So friends, if you like my today's video, it is my humble request to please subscribe my channel. And if you have any particular query or if you want to share any feedback, you can share the same on the comment box in the comment section. Friends, you can also share your feedback directly to me in my mail ID or my WhatsApp number. My mail ID and my WhatsApp number is given in the description box. And friends, if you want me to make my videos on any particular topic, then also give your feedback on the comment section. So this is all for the day. We will be meeting very soon with our next video. Till then, goodbye, and yes, do take very good care of yourselves. Bye bye.